And as Oliver was pointing out, I was going to tell you a little bit about my history at Channel 7. I started in 1980. I graduated from Washington and Lee. I actually was interning in the spring of 1980, and then was offered a summer job, took a week off for graduation, came back and started work there. I've been there ever since. The summer job turned into a full-time job in the fall, and I ended up going to Lynchburg as our bureau chief there. I was there for a little over a year and then went to Blacksburg where we started the New River Bureau. And I had a couple of folks working with me there, Susan Conroy and Ted Stone. You might remember Ted. Ted worked at Channel 10 and Channel 7 for many years, and he's now retired. But we started the Blacksburg Bureau, and of course we still have that there, and that's a really important part of our operation, because the New River Valley, of course, has so much going on. And they come down this way a lot as well. That was 82 to 85, I was in Blacksburg. 85 to 90, I went to Richmond. And, for 40 years, we had a full-time presence in Richmond. Ann Compton, who you might know from ABC, now ABC Radio, she covers the White House, and just recently, I think, celebrated her 40th anniversary of covering the White House for ABC News. And she was our first full-time bureau chief in Richmond. And there were a few after her, and I came in 1985 and was there until 90. Then I came back to Roanoke in 1990, but a lot of people, for whatever reason, still associate me with Richmond. And it's very often I'll be out and about and people will wonder why I'm in Roanoke or ask me if I'm still living in Richmond covering the Capitol. Unfortunately, we don't have a full-time office at the Capitol anymore. Actually, no one does anymore. Some of the newspapers will have a reporter there year-round, but none of the broadcasters in the state have a full-time presence at the Capitol. It's really kind of sad. Back when I was there in 1985, the press room was just jammed with people. We had spigots on the wall where we plugged in our cords to record the video off of the House or the Senate floor, and we would have to fight over, the jacks. Now, I'll go and cover the state capitol during the General Assembly session, and frequently I'm the only one in the room, in the broadcast side of the press room. And it's sad to see what's happened to the newspapers as well. Oliver was talking about changes in the industry, and that's probably, one of the most striking differences that we've seen is just how the fortunes of the newspapers have really fallen as a result of the internet and changing dynamics, habits of readers, and all that. Of course, you know about that as well as I do.